Time aware models in Enterprise Architect 13. Time aware modeling in Enterprise Architect 13 allows you to create incremental versions of a model so you can see how a model evolves over time from one version to the next. Create new versions of model elements automatically without altering the underlying structure of the as-is model. Make comparisons between models, using filters to help identify changes made to any individual elements within a diagram. Enterprise Architect 13 offers comprehensive traceability, so you can see the changes to an element made from one version to the next and easily roll back to a previous state. The time-aware modeling capability in Enterprise Architect 13 has been used to track the evolution of a model entitled Manage Users. In the project browser, there are a number of packages representing the three versions of the Manage Users model. Each package is clearly labeled and includes subtle changes to individual elements that have been made in each iteration of the model throughout the life of the project. Taking a closer look at version 1 of the model, a mistake was made during the requirements elicitation phase of the project, which has resulted in two requirements having the same name, Secure Access. However, the BA or Business Analyst has identified that the two elements have different functions that need to be further defined. Changes were made to the as-is model to rectify the problem, and these changes are stored in the package called Manage Users version 2, as shown on screen. Version 2 of the model has updated requirement 24 to address any underlying problems in the model design and differentiate the two elements. To see what other changes have been made from one version to the next, you can access the diagram properties and select the checkbox entitled Filter to Version. The diagram filter now clearly will outline which requirements have been modified in version 2 of our Manage Users model. The two requirements that have been modified are shown on screen. Now let's open version 3 of our model. Once again, we can repeat the process of using a filter to see what changes have been made in version 3 of our model, allowing us to conduct side-by-side comparison of each model version, watching the evolution of our model through each iteration. I'll now demonstrate how easy it is to clone a structure such as the contents of a package representing a version of a model at a given point in time. Select the design ribbon. Select the package that you wish to clone. Click the drop-down menu called Manage and select the option entitled Clone Structure as New Version. Enterprise Architect populates the name and version number. We want to create version 4 of our model so we can update the name and version number as required. Press OK and then select a folder to clone your model to. Please note that you cannot use the same directory that houses the original model because EA clones all of the model elements. You can see that I have placed the clone model in the package called 2B Architecture. If you want to make changes to a particular element, simply right-click and clone the element as a new version. Enterprise Architect will automatically prompt you for a new version number, which in this case is 4.0. Once we've cloned the element, we can make changes to it without altering the original as-is element or any of the previous versions of the element for that matter. The name of the requirement has been spelled incorrectly, so I'm going to update the name of the requirement and extend the definition to include biometrics. I can also make further changes such as altering the complexity of the requirement and adding a tagged value called biometrics. We can also clone a new element for requirement 26. Once we've made this change, we can delete the connector from the model. With the filter applied, we can easily see which model elements have been updated to version 4. Having created our own time-aware model, we can now compare each version of the Manage Users model, conducting a side-by-side comparison so that everyone on the team can see what changes were made with each iteration. However, these changes have been achieved in a non-destructive fashion, preserving our as-is model. This makes it easy to roll back our model design or compare the model in different evolutionary states. Using Enterprise Architect also provides the advantage of being able to maintain model traceability. For example, we can choose a single element such as requirement 24 and trace how that element has evolved over time. In order to create a traceability diagram, we can use the Insert Related Elements tool, which is available via the Element Context menu. Set the depth level as required. For this particular example, all we care about is the trace connector type. So I'm going to select that now. Refresh the list and select all three items be drawn on screen. You may like to lay out the diagram to suit your individual needs. Now we have a simple diagrammatic representation of how the secure access requirement has evolved through each and every iteration of our model. The Manage Users package started with requirement 24 called Secure Access. We then updated the name to differentiate between requirement 24 and 26, calling the requirement Secure Access to Database. In version 3, we added reference to security, but unfortunately spelled security incorrectly. Finally, in version 4, we further extended the requirement to mention biometrics. So this diagram shows how this single element, requirement 24, has evolved over time. We also have the option of using the Relationships window to provide additional information. The Docked Relationships window is a powerful tool for viewing the relationships between as-is and 2B models. Selecting Source Version and Target Version Report columns brings clarity of relationships. The Relationships window lists all the relationships of the elements currently selected in the diagram or the project browser, showing the relationship type, the direction or navigability of the relationship, any stereotype on the relationship, the names of the source and target elements in the relationship, and characteristics of the source and target elements, such as type, stereotype, role, and cardinality. You'll note that when I select another element on screen, the relationship window automatically updates and is context sensitive for the selected element. This information is presented in a series of columns that you can display or hide to show only the characteristics you require and organize whatever sequence suits your individual requirements. For more information about time-aware modeling, please visit sparxsystems.com for more information.